your hands with water. Apply soap, wrap your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub, and then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Welcome students to online lectures for grade 2. This is week number 15, lecture number 1 of social studies subject. As you know, my name is Mrs. Sadav Amreen. Before going to start, here are some general instructions. What are those instructions? Listen carefully. First of all, dear students, mark your attendance. Okay, dear students, first of all, mark your attendance by clicking the link of the attendance website in the description box below. You have to mark your attendance till your first lecture, and it will be closed after the end of first lecture. Secondly, keep ready your book, notebook, pencil, eraser and sharpener to note down the answers of the questions. If you have any question, please ask question in WhatsApp group. Hope the instructions are clear to follow. Lesson number 10, directions. So what we will learn today, we will learn fill in the blanks, and you have to note down these fill in the blanks starting from 1 till 3 on your copy. And the second thing is true false, so this is also you have to do it on your notebook, 1 till 3. Okay, so today we will do two things. One is fill in the blanks and the second one is true false. And you have to note down this work on your notebook. Understand? Okay. Before going to start today's work, here is a preview of lesson number 10. And the name of the lesson is Directions. We have studied this lesson in our previous lecture. So first of all, we will revise that what we have studied in this lecture. So I will revise all the main points of the lecture here in a quick preview. Okay, so listen carefully. So first of all, about directions. What are the directions? Directions are the ways in which someone moves to know the position of a place or a thing. Understand? Directions are the ways in which someone moves to know. Yani ke direction aisi guideline hai jo kisi cheez ko find out karne mein ya kisi place ki location ko find out karne mein help karti hai. Okay, so directions are the ways in which someone moves to know the position of a place or a thing. So we use some words to give directions. That's why we use some words. And what are those words? Direction words are left, right. So if so we have to go to somewhere in a specific location, then we will sometime we will turn left, then go ahead, and then turn right. These type of the words we use to give directions to someone to reach a specific place. Okay, and the second, if we want to find out something, then we also use these type of words, that something is placed on the top of the rack or on the bottom of the rack, and you can see here there is a bench, and we use some words to give directions like above, in front of, below, behind. Okay, to find something or to give directions to any other person, we use these words also. But here are some special words for directions. And what are those special words? That are north, south, west, east. Okay, west, east, north, south. These are the special words for the directions, and we use these directions in the map. So how to show directions on the map? Keep in mind that the sun always rises in the east and sets in the west. As you are looking in the picture, there is a boy who is standing in front of the sun. Uska face sun ki taraf hai aur uski back jo hai wo west ki taraf hai. Aur jo sun hai, as you can see, the position of a sun is on east side. Theek hai? E stand for east and W stand for west. So boy ka face east side pe hai and uski back west side pe hai. Theek hai? Then uska left side jo hai north side pe hai, left hand side, and the right hand side jo hai uska south side pe hai. So in this way we will use directions on the map. So the sun always rises in the east and sets in the west. As I told you before, that if you face the rising sun in the morning, the north in your left and the south is on your right, and east in your front and west at your back. So the compass is used to show directions. This is the compass, look like a clock. Theek hai? This is used to show the directions on the map, and the pointer is a magnet. It always pointed to the north. You can see the in the clock there are two needles. One is gray and the second one color is red. So you can see that the red color is towards the north side. Okay, so this is the pointer magnet, and it always pointed to the north side. Why it always pointed to the north side? You will learn this thing in your next grades. When you will go in higher grades, you will learn this thing in that grades. Okay, okay. Now here you have to know about the compass and how it look like. It look like a clock, okay, to show the directions, and there is a pointer and that is a magnet, and it always points to the north. You need to remember this thing, that it always points to the north, and the compass pointer is a magnet. Okay, understand? So you need to learn this thing only, that the pointer is a magnet and it always points to the north. Dear students, this lesson was about the directions, and so I have revised all the main points of the directions. So what are directions and direction words that we are used to find out something or to locate a place, and these directions help us to find a location, to find something, and we use different words like right, left, top, bottom, behind, above, and we also use special words on the map to give the directions like north, west, east, south. And you know very well about the sun, that sun always rises in the east and sets in the west, and we use compass to show the directions on the map, and the pointer is a magnet and it always points to the north. Okay, my dear, now we will start our next thing that we will learn today, that is fill in the blanks. So let's start fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks 1 till number 3. Only 3 blanks are there. Okay, so you need to draw the margin line at the both side of the page. Write down at the top CW date and the lesson number 10. Then you will write down the lesson name. After that, you will write down the question. That question is fill in the blanks. Okay, then you will start writing. And you need to follow the 4 lines to write in a good handwriting. Theek hai, achhi handwriting karne ke liye, when you will follow the 4 lines, automatically your writing will be very good. So I always tell you this thing, so I just give a quick reminder that you need to follow the 4 lines. Okay, so the very first fill in the blanks is, there are dash directions. There are 4 directions. Theek hai, there are 4 directions. And what are 4 directions? You can see in the picture, north, south, west, east. Understand? West, east, north, south. So these are the 4 directions. Okay, so the answer in the blank you will write 4, F-O-U-R, 4. There are dash directions, there are 4 directions, F-O-U-R, 4 directions. Then number 2, the sun rises in the dash, the sun rises in the east, E-A-S-T, east. As you can see in the picture, the sun is rising from the east. E stand for east. You can see here is a boy who is standing by looking at the sun or by facing towards the sun. So at that side there is a east. E stand for east. And at the back side there is a W. W means west. Okay, so the sun rises in the east. So what are the spelling of east? E-A-S-T, east. E-A-S-T, east. The sun rises in the east. Okay, now number 3. A dash is used to show directions. A dash is used to show directions. So here is compass. A compass is used to show directions. C-O-M-P-A-S-S. Compass. C-O-M-P-A-S-S. Compass. Okay? A compass is used to show directions. You can see the picture of a compass. And you can notice that the picture of a compass is look like a clock. ठीक है? Compass की picture कैसी लग रही है? जैसे के कोई clock हो. ठीक है? जैसे हमारी clock होती है, wall clock. Understand? So, a compass is used to show directions. C-O-M-P-A-S-S. Compass. Okay, so there are only 3 fill in the blanks. So you need to note down these fill in the blanks in your notebook. Okay, so I will just repeat. There are dash directions. There are 4 directions. Number 2, the sun rises in the dash. The sun rises in the east. Number 3, a compass is used to show directions. A compass is used to show directions. Understand? Hopefully you note down. Okay, my dear, now we will do next. Lesson number 10, directions. Here we will do true, false. Write true or false, okay, on your copy. This work you will do also on your notebook. Understand? So very simply, as you know, what is the procedure to note down a work? You know that you have to draw the margin line, then write down the CW, lesson name, topic of the lesson, then you will write the question. Write true or false, okay? Then you will start writing, okay? So very first true false is, we show directions on a map. So it is a true, because as we have studied that we show directions on the map, okay? And we also studied about the direction words that we will use on the direction map. Kaun se the wo words? Yes, north, south, west, east. So we show directions on a map. It is true. So you will write here true. Number two, the sun sets in the east. No, we have studied about the sun, that the sun rises always in the east, not sets. The sun sets in the west. As you have seen the picture of the boy, the west at the back side of that boy, and at the back side there is written W, and W stand for west. So the sun sets in the west, but here is written the sun sets in the east. So it is wrong. So we will write false, F-A-L-S-E, false. Okay, my dear, number two is false. The sun sets in the east. No, it is false. Number three, the pointer of a compass is a magnet. Yes, I told you this thing. The pointer of a compass is a magnet. Understand? So this is true. T-R-U-E, true. Okay? So number three is true. The pointer of a compass is a magnet. True. So there are only three true false. You need to note down in a very good handwriting in your notebook. And keep remembered one thing, that you need to follow the four lines. In this way you will have a good handwriting automatically. Okay. So must follow my instructions and note down this work on your notebook. Understand? Okay, good. Homework is, here is the homework. Lesson number 10, you know, we have studied lesson number 10, directions. So we need to do the homework of the same lesson. So what we will do, you have to do fill in the blanks that we have done in the class. You need to note down these fill in the blanks in your notebook as a homework also. Understand? And true false 1 till 3 on your copy. So these two things are your homework: fill in the blanks and true false. Understand? And one thing you must keep in mind, that your writing should be very good and neat. And I already told you about the key of making a good writing, and that key is follow the four lines. Understand? Good. In our next lecture we will do question answers, and only question number one we will do in our next lecture, and we will do also question number 11, fill in the blanks, that is from Saudi history syllabus. Okay. So we will do two things in our next lecture: one question answer of social studies lesson number 10, directions, and one question, that was in question number 11 of Saudi history ठीक है, एंड व्हाट वाज व्हाट इज द लेसन नंबर 11, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. ओके, सो वी विल डू दीज टू थिंग्स इन आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. अंडरस्टैंड? ओके. एनी क्वेश्चन? इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन, आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट यू हैव टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप. ओके, गुड. Thank you, my dear students, for listening me. Have a nice day. God bless you. Allah Hafiz.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? I hope all of you good at your homes. This Islamiyat lecture is presented to you by Pakistan International School, Riyadh. For the subject of Islamiyat, grade 2, and I am your Islamiyat teacher, Mrs. Nishad Ismat. Dear students, today we will be starting our new units, that units 14. In the name of our unit is Good Muslims. We will do reading, explanations, and also we will do unit 12, page 54, question answer on copy. Okay? Yes. Dear students, our objective of today's lecture are unit 12, exercise 1, question answer, unit 14, reading explanations and homework question answer, unit 12, exercise 1, page 54, and unit 14, page 59 to 60, reading explanation. So these are the objectives of our today's lecture. I hope you will enjoy today's lecture. But before starting the lecture, here are some instructions for you. So what are those instructions? Let's see. Dear students, first of all, mark your attendance. Keep ready your books, notebooks, pencil, razors, and sharpener, and all the things related to your subject to note down your lecture. If you are giving any assignment, then submit your assignment in your class WhatsApp group. If you have any question, you can ask through WhatsApp group. Hopefully, you will follow the instructions. Dear students, Unit 12, Kindness, Exercise 1, page 54, Question A, B, and D, Oral. Exercise 1, page 54, Question C, Short Answer. Write on notebook. Okay? Write on copy. Yes. Question C. How should we treat our neighbors? How should we treat our neighbors? Answer. We should treat our neighbors with kindness. We should treat our neighbors with kindness. We should help them if they are sick. We should help them if they are sick. Once again, listen. Question C. How should we treat our neighbors? यानी हमें अपने neighbors के साथ कैसा behave, कैसा रवैया, कैसा बर्ताव करना चाहिए? We should treat our neighbors with kindness. We should help them if they are sick. Okay? So hurry up, take out the book, page number 59, Unit 14, Good Muslims. Good Muslims. As a good Muslim, we must follow certain practices in our life. Some of these are given here. As a good Muslim, we must follow certain practices in our life. So one of these are given here. A good Muslim, first of all, always obeys Allah, always tells the truth, gets up early. A good Muslim always obeys Allah. एक अच्छे मुसलमान को अल्लाह ताला का हुक्म मानना चाहिए, हमेशा अल्लाह का हुक्म मानना चाहिए. Always tells the truth, हमेशा सच बोलना चाहिए. Gets up early, और सुबह सवेरे जल्दी उठना चाहिए. A good Muslim loves and cares for his parents, obeys and respects the teachers, respects elders and cares for the young, is good to his neighbors, is polite to everyone, keep his promise, is always mindful of doing thing on time, is always mindful of doing thing on time, never wastes time in useless things, never waste time in useless things, never uses bad words. Yes, once again listen. A good Muslim loves and cares for his parents, obeys and respects the teachers. एक अच्छे मुसलमान को अपने वालदैन क्या ख्याल रखना चाहिए? Obeys and respects the teachers, अपने टीचर की रिस्पेक्ट करनी चाहिए. Respect elders and care for the young, बड़ों की इज्जत करनी चाहिए और छोटों का ख्याल करना चाहिए. Is good to his neighbors, और अपने नेबर्स के साथ भी बहुत अच्छा बर्ताव करना चाहिए. Is polite to everyone, सबके साथ नरमी से शफकत से बात करनी चाहिए. Keep his promise, is always mindful of doing thing on time. Never waste time in useless things and never uses bad words. ठीक है, फजूल काम में, गलत काम में टाइम जाया नहीं करना चाहिए. Never uses bad words, और कभी भी bad word use नहीं करने चाहिए. Okay dear students, understand? A good Muslim, what we will do? एक अच्छा मुसलमान होने से हमें क्या करना चाहिए? अल्लाह का हुक्म मानना चाहिए, हमेशा सच बोलना चाहिए, सुबह सवेरे जल्दी उठना चाहिए, बड़ों का इत्राम करना चाहिए, अपनी टीचर्स का इत्राम करना चाहिए और छोटों के साथ अच्छा बिहेव करना चाहिए, सबके साथ नरमी से बात करनी चाहिए और कभी भी गलत बातें, गलत अल्फाज नहीं कहने चाहिए. ओके, अंडरस्टैंड? यस, आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड वेरी वेल. नेक्स्ट पेज नंबर 60, यूनिट 14, पेज नंबर 60. डज नॉट फाइट ओवर स्मॉल थिंग्स, does not fight over small things, help the weak and does not make fun of them. A good Muslim says salam when he meets someone. A good Muslim says salam when he meets someone, says bismillah before eating and doing good work, says alhamdulillah when he finishes eating and also when we sneeze. When say salam when he meet everyone. First of all, being a good Muslim, we must say salam everyone. जब हम किसी से मिलें तो हमें सलाम में पहल करनी चाहिए क्योंकि ये अल्लाह का हुक्म है. Say bismillah before eating and doing good work. कोई भी अच्छा काम करने से पहले हमें मस्त बिस्मिल्लाह पढ़नी चाहिए बिफोर ईटिंग. ओके, और कोई भी अच्छा काम करने से पहले और खाना खाने से पहले. से अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह व्हेन ही फिनिश ईटिंग एंड आल्सो व्हेन ही स्नीज एंड मस्ट से अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आफ्टर द ईटिंग फिनिश एंड स्नीजिंग. ओके, यस. अ गुड मुस्लिम स्टे क्लीन. A good Muslim stay clean, cares for the sick, is kind to animals, never lies or cheats or steals, never takes other people's thing without asking them. A good Muslim stay clean. अच्छे मुसलमान को हमेशा साफ सुथरा रहना चाहिए. माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज़ यू नो आवर प्रॉफिट हज़रत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सेड, क्लीनलीनेस इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ ईमान एंड बीइंग अ मुस्लिम वी मस्ट स्टे नीट एंड क्लीन. ओके, केयर्स फॉर द सिक, बीमारों का खास ख्याल रखना चाहिए. इस काइंड टू एनिमल्स, और एनिमल के साथ भी अच्छा बर्ताव करना चाहिए. नेवर लाइज और चीट्स और स्टील्स, कभी झूठ धोखा ऐसा काम नहीं करना चाहिए. झूठ नहीं बोलना चाहिए, किसी को धोखा नहीं देना चाहिए. ओके, एंड नेवर टेक अदर पीपल्स थिंग्स विदाउट आस्किंग देम. और कभी भी किसी की चीज़ बग़ैर इजाज़त के नहीं लेनी चाहिए. ओके, अंडरस्टैंड? आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड वेरी वेल. ओके, यस डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो हेयर इज़ अ होमवर्क फॉर यू. व्हाट इज़ होमवर्क? एक्सरसाइज 1, पेज 54, क्वेश्चन सी, short answer on copy and read unit 14 page 59 to 60 two time. Okay, exercise 1 page 54 question C short answer, you must write it on copy and read unit 14 page 59 to 60 at least two time read at home. Okay, my dear students, any question? If you have any confusion, you can ask your Islamiyat teacher in WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you for listening to me in this lecture. So see you in the next class. Allah Hafiz.
Assalamu alaikum everyone and good evening. Hope all of you are fine. Welcome in computer science class. And I am your computer science teacher, Ms. Zarmina. Today we are going to complete part 1 of lecture number 10. So get ready, as today we are going to start our new chapter. Before starting new chapter, here is the review of our previous chapter that was about Windows Paint Drawing Tools. In Windows Paint Drawing Tools, we covered 3 topics in very detail, that is how to use color picker, airbrush and curve tool. These were the topics that we covered in our chapter number 1. So look at your screens. In our previous chapter, we covered these 4 groups: tools, brushes, shapes and color palette. We also studied about the size. How can you increase the outlines of different drawings or the shapes? Then we studied about different shapes and brushes, tools. All of these things have been studied in chapter number 1, that was Windows Paint Drawing Tools. Now moving on to chapter number 2, that is about Windows Paint Editing Tools. So in Windows Paint Editing Tools, we are going to cover 2 groups, that is clipboard and image. Clipboard and image is going to be in chapter number 2. We are going to study about it in detail. So boys and girls, eyes on the screen, as this topic is new for you. Windows Paint Editing Tools. Just focus on the screen. As we are going to cover clipboard and image group today, and before starting in detail, I want you to learn the meaning of these words, okay? We will start with the clipboard and image. This is the larger view of the clipboard and image group. Now look at your screen carefully. In the clipboard group, there are 3 things. The first one is cut, second copy, and third paste. These are the 3 things that are in the clipboard group. While on the image group, there are 4 things. Number 1, select, then crop, resize, and rotate. Crop, resize, and rotate. These are the new things. Dear students, as these words are new for you, before going into the explanation, let us learn their meanings. So we will start with the clipboard. Clipboard. In the clipboard group, there is cut icon, copy, and paste. We will start with the first one. So cut means to remove something. Okay, when you want to remove some part of paper, then you use scissors. Similarly, in computers, when you want to remove some part of your picture, you will use this icon. And cut means to remove. Moving on to the next one, that is copy. Copy means to make a similar to another. Suppose if you want to make another picture again, instead of making again, what you will do, you will just copy it. So copy means to make a similar to another, or you can say similar version or the identical version of the original one. The third one is paste. Paste means to insert into a new place. And when you want to paste something on your notebook, you are going to use glue, right? You will use glue. So in computers, Windows Paint editing tools, what you will use, you will just click on the paste. It will perform the same action as the glue. Okay, to insert into a new place or to put something into a new place. Paste means to put picture into a new place. So basically, you will cut the picture. If you want to place it on another place, then you will just cut the picture and paste it. So paste means to put or insert into a new place. So these are the three things that we studied about the clipboard group. First one was cut, to remove something, copy, to make another or identical version of the original one, and paste, to put or place your picture into a new location. Okay, these are the things that you have to know about the clipboard. These are the words: cut, copy, and paste. So cut, copy, and paste buttons are to cut or copy a picture or object from one part and paste it to another part of the drawing. Okay, we will study it in detail in our upcoming lectures. Now, moving on to the image group. In the image group, there are four icons with the names like, first one is crop. First one is crop. You have to pronounce it as these are new words, so you have to pronounce it. Crop means to remove some part. Okay? If you are, suppose you have drawn a picture and then you want to remove some part of it, what you will do, you will just click on the crop, and crop means to remove some part of the picture or an object. If you want to remove some part, only some part, suppose you want to remove half of your picture, then you will crop it. And crop means to remove some part. Now, second one is resize. All of you pronounce resize. So, resize means adjust the size. Or you can say increase or decrease the size of selected image or picture. Resize means to increase or decrease the selected image or an object. It means to adjust the size. You can increase or decrease the size of your drawings with the help of resize button. Now moving on to the third one, that is rotate. And rotate means to turn the image. As you can see on your screen, that is rotating. That is a picture of mobile and it's rotating. You can rotate your picture upside down or you can rotate it clockwise or anti-clockwise. As you can see right now, it is the picture is rotating in a clockwise direction. Clockwise means in the direction in which the clock moves. Okay, this is, and there are so many other options in the rotate button, but we will study them later. First of all, we have to just learn the meaning of rotate. And rotate means to turn your image. If you want your image upside down, you can rotate it, and you can also move it or flip it with the help of rotate button. So these are the things that you have to know before starting the this chapter, that is chapter number 2, Windows Paint Editing Tools. So that was our today's topic, that you have to know the meanings of all of these hard words. And in the next chapter, in the next lecture, that is chapter number 2, we are going to continue it, but we will cover the selection button in detail. We are going to learn in detail about the selection button. And thank you for listening. If you have any question, you can ask on WhatsApp group. Take care of yourselves. Till then, Allah Hafiz.
बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम प्यारे बच्चों, आप सब कैसे हैं? उम्मीद करती हूँ सब खैरियत से होंगे। प्यारे बच्चों, आज हमारा अरबी का पीरियड है और आज हम पेज नंबर 28, 29 और 31 पढ़ेंगे इंशाल्लाह। सब बच्चे अपनी अपनी बुकलेट खोलें और अपनी बुकलेट का पेज नंबर 28 खोलें। बच्चों, इससे पहले हमने तस्वीर को देखकर उनके नाम और दिए गए जुमलों को पढ़ा और लिखा। उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आपने सबका सबक को अच्छी तरह ज़हन नशीन कर लिया होगा। आज हम तस्वीर को देखकर सवाल जवाब और रंगों के नाम पढ़ें और लिखेंगे इंशाल्लाह। तो प्यारे बच्चों, इन सफात के पढ़ने के जो बुनियादी मकासद हैं वो ये हैं: तस्वीर की मदद से सवालों के जवाब लिखना, मुनासिब अल्फाज तस्वीर के नीचे लिखना, दिए गए रंगों के नाम को पढ़ना और समझना। तो प्यारे बच्चों, सब बच्चे अपनी बुकलेट का पेज नंबर 28 खोलें। सब बच्चों ने खोल लिया? शाबाश। तो इस पेज के ऊपर लिखा हुआ है, दर्ज ज़ैल सवालों के जवाब लिखें। पहले इससे पहले हमने सवाल और जवाब इकट्ठे लिखे हुए थे बुकलेट के ऊपर, वो पढ़े। तो आज हम सवाल दिए गए हैं और उनके जवाब हम खुद लिखेंगे। पहला सवाल है, ऐना तलामीज, शागिर्द कहाँ पर हैं? अतलामीज बिलफसल, शागिर्द क्लास में हैं। फिर दूसरा सवाल है, ऐना मुअल्मा, उस्तानी कहाँ पर है? इसका जवाब है, अल्मुअल्मा फिल फसल, उस्तानी क्लास में है। फिर तीसरा सवाल है, माजा तहमल मुअल्मा, मुअल्मा के हाथ में क्या है या मुअल्मा ने क्या चीज़ उठाई हुई है? अल्मुअल्मा तहमल हकीबा, मुअल्मा के हाथ में बैग है, बस्ता है। प्यारे बच्चों, अब अगले पेज पर आइए। इस पर लिखा है, तस्वीरों को देखें और दिए गए अल्फाज नीचे लिखें। ऊपर सारे अल्फाज लिखे हुए हैं और तस्वीर की मदद से हमने उनके नाम तलाश करने हैं, कौन सी तस्वीर का क्या नाम है अरबी में। पहला क्या है लफ्ज़, कुर्रा दजाजा, मलाइक कितार, मकतब दीक, सबूरा कलम। पहली तस्वीर देखें, ये किस चीज़ की है? फुटबॉल की। फुटबॉल को अरबी में क्या कहेंगे? कुर्रा। फिर अगली तस्वीर देखें, वो एक मुर्गी की है। मुर्गी को अरबी में क्या कहते हैं? दजाजा। क्या कहते हैं? दजाजा मुर्गी। फिर है आगे चम्मच नज़र आ रहे हैं आपको, तो चम्मच को अरबी में क्या कहेंगे? मलाइक। क्या कहेंगे? मलाइक। फिर अगली तस्वीर में देखें, वो एक लाइन नज़र आ रही है आपको, ट्रेन नज़र आ रही है, तो वो क्या है? रेलगाड़ी है। उसको अरबी में क्या कहेंगे? कितार। क्या कहेंगे? कतार। फिर बुक्स नज़र आ रही हैं आपको, लाइब्रेरी, तो इसको अरबी में क्या कहते हैं? मकतब। क्या कहते हैं? मकतब। फिर अगली तस्वीर जो है उसमें एक मुर्गा नज़र आ रहा है आपको, मुर्गे को अरबी में क्या कहते हैं? दीक। क्या कहते हैं? दीक। ये वाली तस्वीर देखें, इसको हम पहले भी पढ़ चुके हैं, इसको क्या कहेंगे हम? ये तख्ता स्याह है और इसको अरबी में हम क्या कहेंगे? सबूरा। क्या कहेंगे? सबूरा तख्ता स्याह। आगे जो है वो तस्वीर है कलम, कलम पेंसिल को कहते हैं और पेंसिल को अरबी में क्या कहेंगे? कलम। ये थे हमारे अल्फाज जो तस्वीर को देख के हमने लिखने थे। अब है बेटा रंगों के नाम। तो ये बुकलेट के ऊपर बेटा सामने आपके बॉक्स बने हुए हैं, जिन रंगों के ये नाम लिखे गए हैं बेटा उनको आपने इस बॉक्स में कलर करने हैं। यानी पहला क्या है? अस्वद। अस्वद किसे कहते हैं? ब्लैक को, स्याह, काला। तो पहला जो बॉक्स है इसको आप ब्लैक कलर करेंगे। फिर है अजरक। अजरक किसे कहते हैं? नीला, ब्लू। और सेकंड वाले जो बॉक्स है उसको आप ब्लू कलर करेंगे, नीला कलर करेंगे। फिर है असफर। असफर किसे कहते हैं? पीले को, पीला यानी येलो कलर, तो इसमें आपने येलो कलर करना है बेटा। फिर है वर्दी, वर्दी कौन सा कलर होता है? पिंक कलर, गुलाबी कलर, इसमें आपने पिंक कलर करना है इस बॉक्स में। फिर नेक्स्ट है, तो प्यारे बच्चों ये था आज का हमारा सबक, जो कि हमने तस्वीर को देखकर उनके नाम सेलेक्ट किए और नीचे लिखे तस्वीर के, उनकी पहचान अब आपको होनी चाहिए कि कौन से तस्वीर का कौन सा नाम है। फिर हमने जुमलों को पढ़ा और समझा, इनके जो सवाल दिए गए थे उनके हमने जवाब लिखे। तो प्यारे बच्चों, सब बच्चों ने अपनी बुकलेट पर इन नामों को अरबी में लिखना है, और सिर्फ नाम इनके उर्दू में याद होने चाहिए ताकि आपकी पहचान हो सके, उर्दू में लिखने नहीं है। और जो जुमले दिए गए हैं, इनके सवाल दिए गए हैं, उनके जवाब आप लोगों ने अपनी बुकलेट पर लिखने हैं। तो यही बेटा आज का आपका काम है। अपना बहुत सारा ख्याल रखिएगा। अगले लेसन तक अल्लाह हाफिज़। फ़ी अमानिल्लाह।